Hey everyone, today I'm going to show how to remove the furnace on my Jayco Jayflight 32 TSBH. The furnace hasn't been firing, so today we're going to attempt to replace the sail switch and see if we can get it to fire again. The purpose of the sail switch is to verify that the blower is functioning before ignition so that propane and heat aren't trapped in the furnace. This job is pretty straightforward, so as far as tools, we should only need a couple. We got a lighter so we can purge the propane in the system. We got just a standard Phillips head screwdriver for removing a couple of screws. And then I have this multi-bit kit that's kind of small so we can actually remove the switch from the blower unit. And then I went to Camping World and picked up this 33063 sail switch assembly. Cost me $34.26. They're awfully proud of it. The sail switch is basically this micro switch with this metal plate attached to it, which I assume would be the sail, that sticks out into the airflow, and once enough is attained, it pushes the switch down, makes contact, and allows ignition. Also included in the kit are a couple of screws for reattaching the sail switch to the blower assembly. So the first thing I'm going to do is purge out the propane in my system. I'm going to do this by shutting off my propane tanks. And we're going to come back to my outdoor kitchen, which is the last thing on the line of my propane system. Get our handy dandy lighter out, and we're just going to light one of the burners until it stops. Burner back off, should be good to go. Next, I'm going to pull the fuse for the furnace system just to pull any electricity off it so I don't electrocute myself or anything else. According to the schedule, fuse number 5, which is a 20 amp fuse right here, is for our furnace. So we're just going to use a pair of pliers, pull that bad boy out, and we should be good. Now I'm going to remove the exhaust port from the side of the trailer. I guess you don't necessarily have to do this, but trying to line it back up when you put it back together, it makes it easier just to do this now. It'll just be these 4 screws here. And take a flathead and just pry it off. The seal and all the gook kind of stays on there, so I'm not too terribly worried about that. But as simple as that. Next, I'm going to remove this screw here, and this screw here holding the propane line to the side of the cabinet. Might come in here and dust this out. As you can see, Jayco just leaves all his garbage in here when they build a trailer. I'm also going to shut the power switch off to the unit while I'm right here. I already pulled the fuse, so there's going to be power, but, you know, safety first, and why not just shut everything off? I also need to remove the 2 screws that hold this hose out of the top outlet of this blower. Alright, now that I've got all the mounting screws out and the exhaust hose out for the top side of that furnace unit, I should be able to just pick this guy up. Pull her back. And rotate her back out towards the bunkhouse. control board, the switch, and the exhaust. It would have been much easier if Jayco had just put a panel outside to, you know, access all this from the exterior of the trailer. All right, so now I'm going to remove the sail switch assembly. First, I'm just going to disconnect these two sets of blue wires off of the assembly. Use my little screwdriver to unscrew it out. And it just comes out like that.
All right, for some reason, I didn't get a video of this, but you need to remove the old switch from the mounting bracket by removing these two screws. Replace the switch and use the new hardware supplied to attach the bracket. Make sure you clean any dirt and lint from the bracket before installing the new switch.
All right, now I'm going to put the whole bracket assembly back into the blower unit. Reattach the wiring. And there we go.
So I want to give this bad boy kind of a test run. I know I don't have gas going to it, but I should be able to tell if it'll even get to the ignition phase with that. So I'm going to go ahead and put the fuse back in and power the unit up, turn the thermostat up, and get it to at least try it on a cycle and see what happens.
It sounded like she tried to ignite, which is a good sign. So we'll shut everything back off and put her back in and hook gas back up to it and see if we can get it to run. Back in, just reversal of how we took it out. Sure we do. Just pick up on the front so that the exhaust port goes out the hole it's supposed to and everything else lines in. Just gonna reinstall the vent hose. Make sure all the screw holes line back up. Go ahead and put the mounting screws back in the tabs. I'm in here, I'm gonna go ahead and turn the power switch back on. Now I'm going to go ahead and put the exhaust port cover back on. Just fit right in there. Make sure sure the seal's on and reinstall the four screws. And there you go. I'm gonna go ahead and put the fuse back in. See if we get some heat. Yep, just heard her kick on. Starting to feel some warm air coming out. So she's igniting again. Hopefully we got a successful furnace repair going on here. We'll find out tonight. It's supposed to get down to like 40 degrees and our electric ceramic heater we've been running probably won't be able to keep up with it. And we want a little heat to keep our tanks warm as well. So we'll find out tonight, is see if everything else is running good. Thanks for watching. Yeah, bye.